This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Tuesday, the 25th day of September in the year 2018. Here's what we're tracking tonight. One of the men in a sex video making the rounds in social media has taken his own life against a backdrop of being accused of rape and being castigated on social media for his actions in the video. The body of the 41-year-old man, Sherwin Apple, also known as Yellow, was found on the seawalls this midday, and investigators believe he committed suicide. The police public relations office confirmed that the discovery of the body was made at the Kitty foreshore. Over the past 2 days, a frenzy was created on Facebook by a number of persons after the sex video surfaced with a man, a young woman, and another young man engaged in a number of sexual acts. Many of the persons who viewed the video recording declared on social media that although at first the young woman appeared to be involved in consensual sex activities, they believe it turned into a sexual assault and rape when she tried to stop the sexual act, but Apple continued. Some public personalities also had their say in the debate over the sex video, with some of them posting the photos of the two men and calling for them to be charged for rape and labeling them as rapists. Sources close to the man's family told News Source that he claimed that the sex acts were all consensual and nothing more than role-playing. He also claimed to family members that a young woman was above the age of consent. A relative of the man said he appeared to have slipped into a depression mood as a result of the social media backlash and was not heard from since last evening, and family members learned this afternoon that his body was found on the seawalls. Police in Linden had launched an investigation into the sex video, but had not yet decided on whether a crime had been committed, since all of the parties involved were not questioned. There are reports this evening that the young woman, who is believed to be the young woman in the video, has denied that she's actually that person in the video. More news in a moment. Welcome back. Four prison officers who are suspected to have colluded with prisoners to get prohibited items into the Lusignan prison are to face charges. Acting Director of Prisons Gladwin Samuel today said based on reports conducted and investigations carried out, prison officers worked together to smuggle a bottle of rum and a pack of cigarettes into the jailhouse. He said the prohibited items were smuggled into the prison for use by prisoners. He also said an investigation was conducted, and that's when a decision was made to file charges against the four officers suspected to have been working along with prisoners to get contraband items into the jailhouse. According to the prison director, in a situation where prison officers agree and work together to smuggle items in, it would be hard to detect the smuggling. He said the standard operating procedures would see prison officers conducting searches to verify that persons are without banned items when entering the prisons. Just yesterday, a search of the Lusignan prison unearthed more than 18 cell phones with a number of improvised weapons, cigarettes, marijuana, liquor, and other prohibited items. Health matters to report now. Minister of Public Health Walter Lawrence has been nominated to be a member of the World Health Organization's Executive Board at next year's World Health Assembly. The announcement came at a regional committee meeting for the Americas being hosted by the WHO in Washington, D.C. Minister Lawrence is attending this meeting. She will serve a term of 3 years from 2020 to 2022. According to the Department of Public Information, the board on which the minister has been nominated to serve plays a significant role in meetings at the World Health Assembly. The board usually gives effect to the decisions and policies of the Health Assembly, advises it, and generally facilitates its work. The annual board meeting will take place in January when the members will agree on the agenda for the World Health Assembly and the resolutions to be considered by the Health Assembly. The World Health Assembly considers reports of the Executive Board, which it instructs in regard to matters on which further action, study, investigation, or report may be required. Turning now to the world of politics, in the wake of some calls for the recent Memorandum of Understanding and agreement signed with China to be made public, Minister of State Joe Harman has indicated that the Cabinet will have to decide whether every MOU signed by the government will be made public.
I don't know if there's a call now being made for every memorandum of understanding signed between the government and a bilateral or multilateral agency for every single MOU to be made public. If that is the call that you're making, then certainly this is something which cabinet will have to determine. But memorandums of understanding are signed between governments worldwide. And the fact that there was such a big hue and a cry about the memorandum that we signed with the Trinidadians that we want to be made public, the president said we'll make it public. And the very day, the next morning, it was in the newspaper full. So there's nothing for us to hide where these MOUs are concerned. And certainly, once it is in the public interest and there are no security concerns, certainly we will make these agreements public.
The government recently released an MOU signed with the Trinidad and Tobago Prime Minister following an outcry from the private sector and social media. The MOU provides the areas of cooperation that the two governments will be focusing on. The MOU and agreement signed with the Chinese government will see Guyana benefiting in a number of areas. The Chinese Foreign Minister paid a visit to Guyana last weekend for the signing of the documents. And finally this evening, the People's Progressive Party Civic is still unclear as to who will be its presidential candidate for the 2020 general elections. At a press conference yesterday, the party's general secretary and former president Bharat Jagdeo said the party has not made a decision and is not focusing on that issue right now. Mr. Jagdeo, however, stated that he is hoping that the matter could be settled before the end of this year.
I saw the newspaper say that I said before the local government elections, I said there are two schools of thought within the PPP. One, and I'm in favor of the first one, which is do it before the local government elections. And there's another group of people in the executive who believe that we should do it after the local government elections.
A number of senior party members have been stepping up their public and media appearances ahead of any decision to choose a candidate. Party youth member Charles Ramson Jr. was the first to indicate an interest to lead the party into the 2020 elections. Other members have been whispering about their presidential candidate ambitions. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight. Gordon Mosley reporting.